When I first seen the car, I thought, holy hell, like, this is really bad. Like, seeing the front of the car was completely caved in, and I'd seen the dash, everything was pushed right up on her, and the steering wheel had a big bend in it, like, must have been from her head, and the windscreen was smashed out. And then seeing her when the boys were holding her in the car, and she was shaking, and her eyes were actually rolling in the back of her head at the time, and that's when, yeah, I got really nervous then. I thought, holy, we're on here, something pretty bad's happened. I knew we couldn't stay there. We had to get something happening before her adrenaline stopped. And yeah, I wasn't sure what was going to happen, to be honest, but she couldn't stay where she was.
I reckon it was about, probably about here somewhere, she blew a tyre. And then she blew her passenger tyre, and then her rim, they reckon, bit in, and then steered straight into the tree here. When I first got here, I was panicking big time. We acted very quickly, got her in the machine, and sent her straight to Dorunda Station.
When I put her in and strapped her arms in the seat, I said, whatever you do, don't move. And then she fell unconscious. I was flying pretty low and slow and ready to land if something did go wrong. Once we got the call that the RFDS was on their way, that was a big relief. Just even talking on the phone, actually, they call back every 10 minutes and just show you some things to do and help, and just to give you a little more reassurance and, yeah, basically back here. Once they get here, it's a big relief.
I couldn't understand why the homestead was dark at the time. The chap said, you know, we can switch the lights on if you want, but there's a few bugs. A few bugs is an understatement. It was swarming, swarming. You could not have the lights on at all. So we basically did most of the work by head torch. What James did, I think, just highlights the resourcefulness and resilience of the country folk. They just step up to the plate, use their smarts, get it done, and walk over hot coals to save somebody else. The situation could have been dire, and the outcome could have been much worse. I believe she's made a very good recovery.
I was very proud of James and what he'd done, and not only James, everyone that was involved. We're very remote out here, so it's extremely important to be able to have the RFDS service